How's it going, everyone? So this video is about the SIG Romeo Zero. Now I've got this mounted up with the Lakeline optic mounting plate. It uses a dovetail. It can work with the G3C. It also can work with the Glock. So that's how I got it mounted up here. And then on the front, I've got AmeriGlow suppressor height sights. I think they're AmeriGlow. I have to double check that, but I'm pretty sure they're AmeriGlow. But so the only reason I brought that up is because with the way that this is designed, you can co-witness without having to have like the slide milled and still be able to use your dovetail or anything like that. You can still co-witness using a mounting plate, and it's actually it works pretty well. So I'm going to test this out for quite some time. And basically, if it doesn't mess up, I'm just going to keep running it like this. If it starts having issues or anything, then I'll look into getting my slide milled by NC Engravers. But right now, I think this setup's fine. And I kind of want to keep it this way just because this is supposed to be a budget build. And if I go out spending a ton of money getting the slide milled and everything, we're creeping far, far away from the whole budget mindset. We already got pretty far away from the budget mindset whenever I switched over to this optic. The reason I switched optics was I was wanting to get away from mounting plates, but this mounting plate actually ended up being, you know, pretty good, and I'm happy with it, and I really don't mind running it just like it is. But I still have a bunch of testing to do with this red dot. I've got to see how long the battery is going to stay alive, and I'm going to touch that subject in a little bit because that's something that I've heard complaints about. And just over the longevity of it, does it hold zero? Because that's another thing that I heard, that it doesn't hold zero. I did take it to the range, and it held zero just fine for me, just for that trip though. So once I've taken it to the range, you know, several times, because over the course of everything I'm gonna do, I gotta get a threaded barrel and all sorts of stuff. Over the course of doing all those things, I'm gonna be putting quite a bit of rounds through this, and we'll be seeing if this thing comes off zero at all. But I will make a follow-up video once I've kind of figured out what the battery life is. Supposedly, like, so it's a lot of people I'm running into are saying, oh, you know, the button to turn it off sucks its location, and it does. So that is one thing. The button is in here behind the lens, and it is absolutely terrible when you need to use it. However, it seems like a lot of people that I talk to don't realize that this is actually one of those that when you lay it down, after 2 minutes, it shuts off. As soon as you pick it up or bump it, it comes back on. And I have tested this out. I let it sit. I set my alarm. I let it sit, and I just barely bumped it and stuff, just trying to see what the minimal amount of movement it has to have to turn on. And it's very sensitive. So I barely bumped it. It came on. So that is where the battery life thing comes into play. With how sensitive that is, that means when you're driving down the road, it's probably going to stay on. It's probably not going to turn off. So driving down the road is going to stay on. When you're walking, it's going to stay on. Pretty much any time this is not stationary on top of a stand or in a safe, somewhere like that, this thing is going to be on. And so we are going to see how long the battery life actually stays alive on it. So far, I mean, I haven't used it a ton. I mean, I've had it for 4 or 5 days now, and a lot of the time it's sat just on top of a place, sitting still and not being brought around with me. But now that I've got this new optic mounting plate, this will be my bring around carry for a while, just to see how well that battery life is and everything. And we'll go over that. So that's something to come. That's not going to be in this video. So it is very small, and this isn't the way I wanted to compare it, but this is the best thing I can compare it to. The Trichicon RMR, this is a clone, but it is pretty much exact size for a clone. All the mounts that I have, this matches the footprint and stuff, so this should be identical to the size of the RMR. So to give you a comparison of how small this is more like your RMSC, the 407 and 507Ks, things like that. This is a very tiny red dot sight. So if you compare it to the width here, you can see right off the bat that this is much skinnier. So this is going to fit better on your G3C, 43X, 48, 43, SIG P365, all those really small handguns. This is going to be kind of the route you're going to want to go. Not necessarily just this one, but the RMSC, the Swamp Fox Sentinel, I think is the one. There's a bunch of them, but so all those micro ones, because these ones, they're going to overhang. This, not this, don't buy this. This is a little eBay cheap clone, but the RMR is going to be, you know, the one that people would get for like the 19, the 17, things like that. I think Trichicon's got a smaller one. I don't even look at them. I can't afford these things. These are not this, but the real ones are just beyond expensive, so I don't even consider these. But yeah, so much smaller. This thing's very compact, and that's part of the reason this plate's really good, because this plate meets that small footprint. The other plates are wider than the handgun, and they just kind of, I don't know, they don't look good. This, I don't think this looks bad. And I can co-witness, and it works. I tested the co-witness. I went to the range. I probably about 80 rounds altogether today at the range. And co-witnessing works. The red dot worked. It didn't fall off zero. Didn't adjust at all. It stayed right on place. I even racked it from there. I am nervous of racking it from it, though, because at the end of the day, the only point of contact this has is with your slide here, like in the dovetail. So all this is just sitting there. So if you put too much pressure, I mean, it is just metal. It could potentially bend up and then cause a permanent like gap there. But it hasn't happened to me yet. I did rack it from it. Not a ton, but I did a couple times just to make sure, you know, everything was holding up good and it was getting bumped around. And if it was going to get knocked off zero because of the plate or anything, I would know about that. So it's staying pretty secure with no issues. So I flipped it around to get you a kind of a closer look here. But yeah, so the Romeo Zero, it's a polymer construction. It does come with a little shield if you want to put a shield on it, but just this camera here. So this particular one, it shows up much bigger than the dot actually looks on the red dot. On here, you would think that this is the 6 MOA, but this one is actually the 3 MOA. So it looks much more than what it actually does on the red dot itself. Now, your button that I was explaining is inside of here. So that little nipple-looking thing that's sticking up right there, that is your button, and it is a pain to get to. It's got different brightness levels, though, so if you just tap them, press it once. Let me see. So, you can see that's much dimmer now. I didn't want to put the aluminum sleeve around it, though, because, for one, that's going to make it wider. And right now, it's, like, at perfect width with the handgun. But it would make it wider. And then, also, I like this texturing. You know, when I grab it and stuff, I got some texture to grip onto. So I decided to keep that just like that and not put the aluminum shield. It would give it more protection with the aluminum shield. Your windage adjustment is right there. Your elevation is right here on the top. And there's no locking screw, so it just, you adjust the windage and elevation. And they're very firm. They're not loose. So when I was adjusting it, I was kind of nervous because I had to put a lot more pressure than I expected, but they are very firm adjustments, and I think that's what helps it hold zero. We'll see the longevity of it and everything. I know I did a poll to see which red dot I should get, and on there was the 407K and all those things. So the reason I went with this was the price point. I got this for $170 on Amazon. I don't know if it was some sort of special, but I did get it for like $170, which was $130 some odd cheaper than the Holosun 507K. But, so I'm still going to get the Holosun. I wanted something to compare it to that's higher end. I've tested out like, the ADE Red Dot Sight. That's, $80, and it does really, really well for $80. I did the Clone Trigicon here, and for $40, this was an absolute turd. So I wanted to be able to compare, if I just went straight into the Holosun 407K, yeah, I'm gonna say, oh, this thing's fantastic. I love it to death. It is perfect. You should spend every bit of $300 on it. Yeah, I'm gonna go into saying that because the only thing I've got to compare it to, sample size wise, is a $80 ADE Green Dot Sight and a $40 eBay one. So I needed something to give myself comparisons to. And I felt like getting a mid option to be able to compare, it's $130 cheaper, it's gonna make me a little bit more knowledgeable whenever I go to review something like the Holosun 407K. I've shot Trigicons and stuff like that, but I didn't have a lot of seat time with them. So I don't really know a ton about the Trigicon RMR that was on the Glock 17 that I shot. But so now this is going to give me the ability to have like a midway point to compare and see, is your money really better spent spending the extra $130? So that's why I went this route. I'm still getting the Holosun 407K, and that'll happen in the near future. I don't know if I'm going to stick it on the G3C necessarily because I want to keep this a budget build. It might go on the next gun that I get, but I'll probably get the Holosun 407K before I even get the next gun. And yeah, so this is the first look at the Romeo Zero. This thing's been pretty cool so far. I'm pretty happy with it. I like the idea of being able to co-witness and everything with it, and it's held zero for me. I know this video was a little bit longer and I kind of got off topic a lot, but there's a little bit of discussions I wanted to have and things I wanted to just kind of let out there, like the whole Red Dot Sights. I know I did, like I said, the poll, and I wanted to explain why this happened. So, but yeah, so far this build, I'm actually really happy about that. If you're wondering why my laser flashlight combo on here is no longer on here, that stopped working. I brought that up in my last video I made. Well, actually, it's not gonna be my last video because there's several that haven't been uploaded yet. So it just kind of stopped. It was working. I was at the range, clicked the button, and now it's not coming on at all. I contacted ADE to ask them about that. I'm gonna see what they got to say before I do a whole video about that. But yeah, I bought new batteries and everything, made sure it wasn't the batteries. So I had a four pack of different CR2 batteries, and none of them are making it turn on. So it just kind of stopped working. So waiting to see what ADE says, and then we'll discuss that in the future. But that's what I got for you for the first look at the SIG Romeo Zero. It's been pretty cool so far, and like I said, I've got to do a ton more testing. I want to figure out the battery life and everything on this, and I'm gonna make sure that I'm using it more than the average person does. That way, the drastic, like if the battery life only lasts a week, the average person could probably expect, 3, 4 weeks out of it. But I have a feeling it's gonna last much longer than like a week. I have a feeling it's gonna be, I'm gonna make an update video 6 months or more down the road. But most people don't like changing batteries that often because you have to remove the whole dot because the battery's underneath. It doesn't have any system up top where you remove the battery. And I understand why, when they're so compact like this, you really don't have too many options unless you make the sight bigger. And that's gonna kind of be counterintuitive to what they're trying to do. So I understand why the battery's underneath, but that's why battery life's really important to people because they don't want to pull these things off. That's what I got. If you would, hit the like button, subscribe to the channel. I got a ton more videos to come. I'm gonna be putting this through way more ringers and see how well it does. And still, I guess, on a search for a flashlight and or laser flashlight. Primarily a flashlight. If I get a laser, that's cool. But still gotta find something for this so I can get a holster custom made to this and I can actually carry it the way I want to. But that's what I got. I'll catch y'all later.